Do you know the real story behind the Nun? No problem. I am here to tell you the real story behind the Nun movie. Take your seat and watch the full video. I'm Paul and you are watching Explore Everything channel. Okay, start. The Conjuring movies and their subsequent adherents are famous for giving paranormal true stories a big Hollywood makeover. So far these movies have taped into several investigations carried out, or concocted, a pair of real-life spook chasers whose cases have captured the pop culture imagination despite being discredited by the non-believers. Even if you don't accept that their exploits confronting the supernatural are real, and you probably shouldn't, there's no denying that the Warrens have inspired some successful scare fare. The Nun is the latest movie to stem from the Conjuring cinematic universe and the titular character is anything but holy. Also known as Valak, the demonic nun first appeared in The Conjuring 2, a movie that was loosely inspired by the well-documented Amityville and Enfield haunting cases. The character also pops up at the end of Annabelle Creation, which centers around a creepy doll with its own basis in the Warrens' brand of paranormal wisdom. In the movies, the Valak character was introduced to connect these stories somewhat cohesively. No entity that goes by that name has ever been mentioned in the Warrens' actual case files. However, among practitioners of the dark arts and connoisseurs of demonology, Valak is a being that can be traced back centuries. That being said, the way the Hellspawn has been portrayed in the Conjuring universe is very far removed from the demon's proper mythology. For a start, the real Valak isn't a nun or a woman for that matter. At least not according to demonic history anyway. According to the Lesser Key of Solomon, which is a collection of grimoire translated from ancient texts by famed occultists Leicester Crowley and S.L. MacGregor Mothers in 1904, he's a high-ranking hellspawn with the sweet mode of transport. Crowley and Mothers dedicated their life to his shenanigans and were even prone to carrying out the odd freaky ritual from time to time. If anyone knew about demons, it was these delinquents. Other translations of these texts, which can be traced back to King Solomon, who apparently conversed with Valak and countless other demons, have different wording. But the characteristics that define Valak are always the same: a childlike entity who rides a two-headed dragon, possesses great knowledge and commands his own demonic legion. There's no mention of him being a nun, but maybe he likes to dress up? Reading about this Valak has ruined a nun for me. If they stuck to the original mythology, then the movie would potentially feature demonic armies, dragons, and treasure hunting, in either the physical sense or the metaphorical, spiritual one. A nun haunting an abbey is fine, but it's hardly befitting of the legacy of a hell commander of this stature. Thanks for watching and don't forget to share this video with your friend and family, and please subscribe Explore Everything YouTube channel and get daily interesting videos. See you next time.